The D-Wave quantum computer runs problems that are formulated as binary quadratic models. One type of binary quadratic model is a QUBO model, which stands for Quadratic Unconstrained Binary Optimization. This model represents a problem using variables that can take the value 0 and 1. In this video, we'll walk you through what happens when you send a QUBO problem from your computer over to the D-Wave quantum processing unit using our Ocean software development kit. If you're new to the world of binary quadratic models, you might want to check out our video that will introduce you to these different models. For this demo, we'll be working with a very simple problem, which goes like this. We have three boxes, and they cost $25, $20, and $30. We can buy as many as we want, and we have $50 to spend. If we want to spend as close to $50 total as possible, which boxes should we buy? We can formulate this problem with a QUBO equation. We have a binary variable for each box, which indicates whether we're going to buy the box or not. A 1 indicates that we'll buy the box, while a 0 indicates that we won't buy it. Now, we can look at how close to our target value of 50 our total box purchase cost might be. This can be modeled by looking at the expression 50 minus 25x1 minus 20x2 minus 30x3. In this expression, if we don't buy any boxes, the value is 50. We're $50 away from our target value of $50, so we haven't done very well. If we buy all of the boxes, the value is negative 25. We're now only $25 away from our target value, so we're doing a bit better. Our tools are built to find the minimum value of expressions like this one. Notice that the minimum value of our expression as written would buy all of the boxes for a value of negative 25. To make sure that we only buy boxes that are close to the value of 50, we want to find the x values that make this expression as close to 0 as possible. To do this, we need to square the whole expression. This acts like an absolute value, and you can read up on this technique and many others in our problem formulation guide that's linked below. To run this problem on our quantum processing unit, or QPU, we'll first consider our QUBO model's logical form. To do this, we would need to multiply out this expression and simplify some terms, since we'll need to clearly see our linear quadratic terms. There's a few other tricks to putting this in the right form, and these are all covered in the same problem formulation guide that I referenced earlier. To draw the logical graph for our problem, we have a vertex or node for each variable and an edge between each pair of variables. The linear coefficients in our equation appear as vertex weights, while the quadratic coefficients are edge weights. Now that we have our QUBO graph, let's take a look at what happens when we run this problem on the QPU. We start with our QUBO graph that we created. The Ocean software tools convert the QUBO model into an icing model. This is done by transforming our problem from one that uses binary or 0-1 variables to one that uses a new set of binary variables that take the value negative 1 and positive 1. This is called an icing or easing model. For this problem, we show here what the icing graph looks like. Notice how the numbers on our nodes and edges have changed because of the mathematical transformation. Next, the icing problem is transformed to fit onto the physical chip. Sometimes a variable is assigned its own individual qubit that represents it, and other times a variable might need to be stretched across multiple qubits. This process is called embedding. Using D-Wave's problem inspector, we can see how our three-variable problem is mapped onto four qubits on the D-Wave 2000Q processor. On the left, you see the graph of our QUBO problem with three variables, and on the right is our embedded problem that uses four qubits. Note that with our new Advantage quantum processor, we're able to run problems like this one without using extra qubits. We're using the older processor here so we can demonstrate these concepts with a small, simple problem. With node and edge weights, this four-qubit embedded problem now looks like this. We've stretched out our logical variable 3 across two connected qubits, which we'll call 3A and 3B. These two qubits, 3A and 3B, are what we call a chain since they act together like one of our logical variables. Finally, the values in our problem are scaled down to the physical ranges that our QPU accepts, which is negative 2 to positive 2 for the qubit weights and negative 1 to positive 1 for the edge weights. This can mean that if our problem has really large values, they'll be scaled down to a much smaller range. Here we see our scaled down embedded icing graph. This is the problem that's implemented onto the physical QPU. Notice in particular that the weight on the edge between 3A and 3B has now become 0 when it used to be 1. The much larger entries, like 375, have forced this value of 1 to be so small in the scaling process that it's pretty much 0. When this problem runs on the QPU, we might get back a solution that looks like this. In this solution, we're seeing that our qubits 2 and 3B returned a value of positive 1, and qubits 1 and 3A returned a value of negative 1. But remember that qubits 3A and 3B are chained together, which means that they represent one logical variable. For our solution to make sense, they need to have the same value. As a user, we can control how strong that chain is using the chain strength parameter in our programs. If our results return from the QPU with a broken chain like this, our software tools will work to resolve the problem and choose one of the values for your logical variable. Note that there are a few different methods that our software tools can use to resolve this issue, and they may not result in the best solution. Your best option is to update the value for your chain strength parameter first and rely on the software tools to resolve it as a backup option. At this point, our solutions are translated back into the 0-1 variables that belong to the QUBO model we originally submitted. This means that each negative 1 is replaced with 0, and each positive 1 remains the same. This is now the solution that's returned to the user. Variable 1 has value 0, variable 2 has value 1, and variable 3 has value 1. When we translate this back to our original problem about which boxes to purchase, this corresponds to the solution where we should buy the boxes that cost $20 and $30, and not the box that costs $25. As you've seen, there's a lot going on behind the scenes when you submit a simple problem to our QPU. If your Ocean programs are not performing as expected, it's a good idea to think about some of these steps to see if you can improve your program. A good start is to take a look at the corresponding icing matrix or play with the chain strength parameter. Thank you for tuning in to learn more about how to use D-Wave's quantum computers in the Ocean SDK. Check out some of our other videos to learn more about how you can start developing quantum applications today with our Leap Cloud platform.